Welcome. Let's have a look at the building management functionality available for the Connect Box. Please be aware that not all of this shown information and functionality is available for the box on-premise variant. A popular functionality is the alarm functionality. Let's have a look how it works. Via this tab, you see all the alarms that have been set up across your boxes. You can filter them by different parameters. You can access them directly from here or already see the most important information. For example, the equipment type that this is alarm applicable for, in this case it's an electricity meter. It gives me always an alarm when the consumption is between 3 or above 7 kWh. In the details you can see the different alarm events that have been triggered and you can acknowledge them, close them, or even reopen them. Let's have a look at a certain box and see how we set up alarms. Let's go to the Siemens headquarters demo device. Click at the alarm tab. When we look at the configuration, you can see that we already have one temperature alarm set up. Let's have a closer look at it. I selected the property of a CO2 sensor, based on LoRaWAN, and already configured a lower and upper threshold to 16, respectively 25 degrees. I also get notified to my email whenever this alarm triggers. Let's leave it unchanged for now. Also, here you can see per box the alarm history and different alarms that have been set up. Another available building management function is the dashboard functionality. Here you can, for example, create floor plan-based dashboards as I set it up here. For example, in this room 407, you see the location, the humidity, the room temperature and even the battery level for a certain device in an easy way. In this case, it's an actuator to control the heating system in the room. Alternatively, you can set up a more numerical overview or you can add multiple floor plans. For example, here two meeting rooms on the fifth floor of the same building, where I track the actual room temperature and the temperature set point, again of the heating system. And in the very same room I also track, for example, the CO2 level. I can add additional charts as single values or data tables as you can see here by simply selecting the relevant properties from the list of connected equipment. Let's leave it unchanged for now and go back. These new dashboards are added by simply drag and drop an image into the browser, for example the floor plan that you saw before, or setting up a completely new dashboard for the more number-based visualization. Another way how to visualize are data graphs. For example, I can show the data trend of the last 30 days of my actuator 2 you saw in the dashboard. I can show the humidity, I can visualize the battery voltage and also the temperature as a time series based graph. Here another room. The meeting room from before. This one has a bit more data and a little bit different visualization style as well. To achieve this, you can change the color of your graphs, change the parameters of the axis to customize the image. And also here you can add different values to this graph at any time. For example, the CO2 level of the CO2 sensor installed in the room. Here you see that it seems to actually have a problem. In order to assess the problem, there is a live data view available for all box variants, including the box on-premise. Let's not save the changes because this is really not a beautiful graph, and let's have a detailed look at actuator 2 and actuator 4. As you can see, there is indeed a problem with actuator 2. Actuator 2 connected last time 22 days ago, whereas for actuator 4 everything seems to be okay, and it connected last time 10 minutes ago. Also, all the data comes in properly. I use the live data view a lot for troubleshooting the device and it comes in very handy to detect issues. Going back to the graph, an important question comes up. What if I want to see data that is longer in the past than 30 days? For this, there is the Create Data Archive Request function. With this, you can access the data of the last year, you can group that data by month and or by day, and you can export it as a file for further analysis. For example, as CSV, an Excel datasheet or as a JSON file. The property data from the graph is automatically added. You can select additional properties of already configured equipment and you can send an archive to any user that is added to the organization. You can request the download with the button, and it gets directly sent to the specified email address. Thank you very much and see you in the next video.